that update from Mission Control. We are unfortunately scrubbing today's operations.
A first of its kind scrub at Cape Canaveral. Relativity Space was relatively quiet today as it tried to launch its 3D printed rocket. The launch window, which opened at 1 this afternoon, closed a little over an hour ago, and the rocket never got off the ground.
West 2's Brevard County Bureau Chief Scott Heidler is live at Kennedy Space Center tonight. And Scott, do we know what caused that scrub?
Yeah, we do. Relativity Space saying that there was an issue with the temperature of the propellant in Terran 1, that's the name of the rocket, in its second stage, and that they're working to fix the problem right now. Terran 1 was fueled up and ready to go. It appeared in the first hour or so of the three-hour launch window from 1 to 3 p.m. that the pre-launch process was going well. But then, after the countdown was put on hold and restarted several times, and then an auto abort was even recycled, the launch was finally waved off with less than 40 minutes left.
We're currently waiting for an update from Mission Control.
The issues focused on the temperature of the propellant in stage 2 of the 110-foot rocket exceeding launch limits in the rocket that's made of 85% 3D printed material. Relativity Space is headed by former SpaceX and Blue Origin engineers. The name of this mission, Good Luck, Have Fun, or GLHF. Even without a launch today, the company is cutting new territory.
Pretty critical that they're going down this path of 3D printing. You can do a lot of different types of structures with 3D printing that you can't do with the traditional manufacturing techniques. And of course, they hope to then do it in a cheaper way and a more rapid way.
As this was to be the first ever Terran 1 launch, the two-stage test rocket is expendable. The main goal was to gather as much data as possible. Both the rocket and the 9 Aeon engines have been designed from scratch by the startup space company. No word yet from Relativity Space when that next launch window will be. Simply signing off their launch coverage today, saying that there'll be an announcement coming over the next couple of days on Twitter. Reporting live at the Kennedy Space Center, Scott Heidler, West 2 News.